how judged do you feel when you go out with a group of your friends, you hang around, you have a good time, you chill together, you take a lot of pictures. But when it comes to sharing those pictures, the disappointment in their eyes that you don't own an iPhone and hence they cannot airdrop the pictures to you. That's gotta hurt, right? But not to worry, I'm here to give you three simple ways to transfer your photo from iPhone to Android. Now I'm going to talk about Telegram in detail, but before that I need to acknowledge the most common and the most obvious choice, which is WhatsApp. Now when we send pictures through WhatsApp, resolution plays a big issue where the files are compressed. So we came up with a hack that we can send the pics in document format and hence the job is done. But then again, process in iPhone is pretty lengthy where you need to transfer pics from one place to another to be able to finally send it across as a document. Hence, I would suggest Telegram. Now, I don't know why people don't talk about it much, but Telegram lets you send a file size of maximum 2 GB. Now, what else you need? Now, here the best part is that interface will remain almost the same, just like WhatsApp for iPhone and Android. Now, while sending picture through Telegram, you just need to go to attachments. Over there, you select your picture and then press the three dots on the top right corner. And then you send the picture as a file. So you need to select keep HEIC. So this way, your pictures will be going across in the same format and the same file size. So you don't need to think much, you can just directly select the photos and send it across. So AirDroid is an app which can come in handy anytime and it is in heaven for transfers between Android and iPhone. Now once you've downloaded AirDroid on both your devices, that means Android and iPhone, it is very important to note that both the devices should be on the same Wi-Fi. And in case you don't have your Wi-Fi, then you can always start a hotspot and bring your other device on it. Now, once you sign up and then sign in later on, you can discover the other phone in the same vicinity. And once connected, a chat box will open up from where you can send all your photos, which will reflect in the chat box of the other device. And that way, your photos will reach its destination without losing any quality. So, AirDroid is used when both the phones are in the same vicinity, just like these ones. But what if your friend over here is sitting at home and chilling and you are waiting here for your pics? In that case, go and download Send Anywhere. Now this app can be used in two ways. Firstly, if both the phones are in same vicinity, then you just need to select pics that you need to send and then a code would generate which you need to insert in the other device. And that way, the transfer will start. But as I said, there is another way as well. For that, you select the photos that you need to send across and then select Share Link. This way, a link would be generated which could be shared across your friends who are not available in the same room as you are. And the data will be safe on the cloud from where multiple of your friends can download the content. But over here, one thing should be noted which is very important. The link that you have generated and the data which is there on the cloud, it will expire in 2 days. That means your group of friends has precisely 48 hours to download the content from the cloud. Now I know that I told you that I'm gonna give you three simple ways to transfer your photos from iPhone to Android. But what if you do not want to download any apps? In that case, I'm here for a bonus one. Yes, snapdrop.net is a website where you do not need to download anything. And in fact, there is no file size limit as well. You just need to go on the website and your job will be done. How you ask? Let me show you. Now on this website also, you need to make sure that both your devices are on the same Wi-Fi or else on each other's hotspot. After that, you need to discover the other device, appreciate the quirky name that they give to your device and start sharing. This way, you can send large files across and you do not need to download any app as well. I hope you like the suggestions that we made and I really hope that we were able to make your file transfer hassle-free. And as a result, we were able to bridge the gap between iPhone users and the Android users. This is me, Hardik, signing off. See you next time. But before that, don't forget to like the video, comment down your experiences. And apart from that, don't forget to subscribe to the channel and click the bell icon. And also, if you're an Apple geek just like us, then don't forget to download the IGB app as well. I'll see you next time. God bless.